On the next WoodSongs, they go from honky-tonk to old-time country. The Little Willies are here with Norah Jones. Still you're not satisfied. I paid the cost and loved the loss, but still I worship.
The television broadcast of the WoodSongs Old Time Radio Hour is made possible in part by Kentucky Proud and the Kentucky Department of Agriculture. Supporting Kentucky-grown farm products, used worldwide and in your hometown. Acoustic Rainbow, introducing songs from independent artists and small labels to over 1,200 acoustic format radio stations worldwide. Online at acousticrainbow.com. Support is also provided by viewers like you. Information on how to become a WoodSongs partner and support the growth of grassroots music is online at woodsongs.com. And by Insight Communications, providers of cable, high-definition television, and broadband internet service.
Here on the Louisiana Hayride, his name is Hank Williams. Addressing
cowboy. On the Grand Ole Opry,
Bill Monroe and his Bluegrass Boys.
Hi, this is Bruce Horns.
Hi, this is Kevin Moore.
Hey, folks, this is Bela Fleck.
Hi, folks, this is Sam Bush.
Hello, this is Odetta.
This is Joan Baez, and you're listening to the WoodSongs Old Time Radio Hour.
And now, gather the family around and sit back in your easy chair. It's time again for the WoodSongs Old Time Radio Hour, our worldwide celebration of grassroots music. Let's welcome folk singer, author, and tree hugger, Michael Jonathan.
All alone with you on a winter's evening, it's me and you, just you and me on a winter's evening, falling winter snow, a fireplace glowing in your eyes tonight. Silent firelight this winter's eve. I believe in winter song. I believe in snow falling down January 1. But the beauty of this winter's night can't compare to the precious sight of you alone with me this winter's eve. I believe in winter songs. I believe in snow falling down, January wine and firelight. But the beauty of this winter's night can't compare to the precious sight of you alone with me this winter's eve. Falling winter snow, a fireplace glowing in your eyes.
And welcome to the historic Kentucky Theater. And here we are in our hometown of Lexington, Kentucky, the crossroads of America's folk and bluegrass music, the gateway city to the beautiful Appalachian Mountains, where this art form was really born and got spread all over the world. We're so grateful that artists do come here to be on our stage, where we celebrate this grassroots music world, this global art form. We present it as a beautiful and precious diamond, and like a diamond, it has many different facets. It's folk and blues and bluegrass and country, old-timey, new singer-songwriters. It's rock and it's classical. Sometimes it's even opera. We celebrate it all on this stage because we love it all. It's a very passionate, beautiful art form. And you don't have to be famous to be on our broadcast. You just have to be very, very good. And we're devoting our entire hour to one band that has come out with an absolutely beautiful album. We got it, we heard it, we loved it, and we invited them here, and we're very grateful that they said yes. We're going to get into it. It's a CD called For the Good Times, and they're going to start with a Ralph Stanley song called I Worship You. Please welcome Lee, Jim, Richard, Dan, and Norah. It's the Little Willies on the Wood Songs, Old Time Radio. From their brand new CD called For the Good Times, let's say hello to guitar player and co-lead vocal on that, Richard Julian. Let's say hi to Richard.
Hey there.
Your co-vocalist on that was the wonderful Norah Jones. It's nice to have you both here.
Thank you.
So, Richard, tell me about the Little Willies. How did the band form? There's five on stage. There's Norah and four incredibly handsome musicians that are performing with her. How did you guys get together?
Well, there was an audition that we had to be handsome for. I was the last one to join, so I'm not exactly sure of the answer, but I did a recording session one time with Norah where we did a Waylon Jennings song, and she said, tonight I'm going to play with this, you know, group, and I knew everybody in the group, and she said, we're going to play some country songs, why don't you come sing? And so I did, and then I joined, so that was my entry.
That was your entry.
Yeah, let's but that was the first gig, so, you know.
Well, let's get Lee, the bass player, to come up. Lee Alexander playing bass. So tell me about the inception part of the Little Willies. You've been performing and working with Norah for a while, so.
Yeah, we met when we both first moved to New York. I had been there for about 6 months, and then I met her, and we started doing some jazz gigs around New York, and not too long after that, we started sort of writing music and doing what evolved into her thing, basically.
Now, you helped co-write a lot of the songs on Norah's first hit album. So as a group, the individual members of Little Willies are friends.
Yeah, for sure.
They're friends and they're...
Yeah, I think the concept was basically we just wanted to have a band. We could play these songs that we loved and have no pressure. Not, you know, she wasn't the band leader. He wasn't the band leader. Jim wasn't the band leader. We just play in clubs in New York and just have a good time.
Well, let's continue the good time. We're going to get back into the record. It's called For the Good Times. It's a wonderful CD, and here's a good song called Remember Me. It's the Little Willies on the WoodSongs, Old Time Radio.
You told me once that you were mine, alone forever, that I was yours till the end of eternity. But all those vows are broken now, and I will never be the same except in memory. Remember me when the candlelights are gleaming. Remember me at the close of a long
CD is called For the Good Times, and let's say hello to guitar player extraordinaire, Mr. Jim Campilongo, playing the guitar, electric guitar, one of the Little Willies. Now, you're a very accomplished guitarist. You've been at it for a long time. You're a producer. You even do writing work for Guitar Player magazine.
Yeah, sometimes.
So how long have you been the writer part?
I just did actually a couple of guest columns about hillbilly jazz and some of the guitarists I really loved, and that was about it. You know, I mean, that was when spell check was invented, so my career flourished.
And speaking of your career, I mean, you have like 9 or 10 solo albums, instrumental albums of your own.
Thanks for mentioning that. Yeah, I do. I do instrumental music, and write a lot of songs and. Yeah, at this point, I have 9 records out, so.
So now, good take. That's pretty good.
Thank you.
I suggest Orange.
Oh, you're right.
I do.
So, like, how old were you when you started playing the guitar?
I was actually about 13.
13? Well, it was like in your family, or is this something that you just listened to the radio and got inspired?
I think it was my older sisters, more than anything, because my parents were, they were into like Herb Alpert and stuff like that. But my sisters were into Jimi Hendrix and the Beatles and Dylan and the Incredible String Band and Nitty Gritty Dirt Band and stuff. Like, they really had good taste. So I kind of heard it through the wall and, next thing I was buying the same records.
Right. And the rest is history, as they say. Well, let's get back into your record, hear more of your music. We're going to hear more of Richard singing the lead on this next one. It's from the CD For the Good Times. It's brand new. The tune is Diesel Smoke. It's the Little Willies on the Wood Songs, Old Time Radio.
Truck on a mountain road, I got a hot rod rig and I'm flying low. My eyes are filled with diesel smoke. Hairpin turns ain't no joke. Diesel smoke.
Dangerous curse.
I was out last night drinking beer with the guys. Got an aching head and bloodshot eyes. I lit up with a pretty little dame. I didn't even know her name. Diesel smoke. If I'm going to deliver this hotshot freight, I've got to get going cause I'm running late. These mountain grades are mighty steep. Can't stay awake, can't get no sleep. Diesel smoke. She's got the coffee already made. I gotta keep my eyes upon the road. I'm coming down the hill with a heavy load. Diesel smoke.
Dangerous curse.
Well, I must have closed my eyes for a while, cause here I am and I'm running wild. Burn my brakes, strip my gears. Gonna have to ride her down, I fear. Diesel smoke. To this fix all because I tried to mix diesel smoke.
Dangerous curse.
Diesel smoke.
Dangerous curse. Dangerous
Jim Campilongo on that monster lead guitar. Richard Julian on lead vocals. And let's say hello to the other vocalist. Grammy Award winner Norah Jones is here on the piano.
Hi.
9 Grammys, 37 million albums sold, and you're mostly known as a jazz artist. And here, this album is really just a lot of just the wonderful American early country songs.
Well, yeah, I guess jazz and country, both very early American traditions, right?
Now, did a lot of this come from your upbringing in Texas? I mean, you're known
probably.
As a New Yorker, but you kind of grew up in Texas.
Yeah, I grew up in Texas, and my mom's family's from Oklahoma, so definitely came from that side.
So what were you listening to as a young girl?
A lot of oldies radio. I don't know. I listened to a lot of Willie Nelson and Hank Williams growing up.
Yeah. So you find that that's still the genre of music that calls to you the most?
I feel most at home listening to country music. I always have.
Yeah. So how did the inception of the Little Willies come to be? I mean,
my take on it?
Yeah.
We all just wanted to play some country songs.
It's just literally just a very loose, just get together as buddies. And
yeah, I mean, we all just love music, and we're always playing music for each other, and we all have an attachment to these old country songs from different places, you know, where we all grew up, and I guess we just wanted to play them.
Well, speaking of different places, I mean, each individual band member, very successful in their own right, but it's not like you're all centrally located where you get to rehearse every Monday and Tuesday evening or something. Right?
This is never a rehearsal band anyway. It's more of a just go to the bar and play the songs band. I think, what would we say, our recording sessions are our rehearsals, basically.
Yeah, so this is sort of like a global WoodSongs rehearsal session for you. Yeah,
well, rehearsal.
Welcome to the session, that's right.
Yeah.
So how long have the Little Willies been together as a group of friends, performing?
As friends or
performing.
I think since 2004.
So it's been a while.
Does that sound right? 2002, sorry.
Yeah, earlier.
2002.
And this is For the Good Times, is your second album as a group.
Yeah, this is our second album. It's been like 5 years since our first album. But
it took us a long time to not write the material.
Yeah. It's all cover songs, pretty much.
Right, right. But you pick good stuff. The name Little Willies, I can't not ask.
Oh, I came up with that one, obviously.
You did.
We were joking that we wanted to be a Willie Nelson cover band, so I thought the Little Willies was really cheeky and funny,
mm-hmm.
and kind of stuck. We didn't really know we'd be playing big radio shows with that name at the time.
Yeah.
We thought we'd just be playing at this little bar in New York, but...
Well, and here you are, right?
I like the name.
I think it's a good name. I think the audience likes the name. It sticks.
The look on Richard's face right now is pretty priceless.
Priceless.
They don't have to deal with the social ramifications.
Right. Yeah, it speaks a lot for the guy members of the group. We're not going to go there, though.
No, it doesn't speak a lot. That's
it speaks
very
much.
Little.
It speaks very little. Which brings us into the next song, written by Hank Williams. It's one of my favorite songs on the album. Written by Hank Williams. It's called The Lovesick Blues. It's the Little Willies on the WoodSongs. Old Time Radio.
I got a feeling called the blues, oh Lord, since my baby said goodbye. Lord, I don't know what I'll do. All I do is sit inside. Oh Lord, that last long day she said goodbye. Such a beautiful dream. I hate to think it's all over. I've lost my heart, it seems. I've grown so used to you somehow. I've got the lovesick blues. said goodbye. Lord, I don't know what I'll do. All I do is sit inside.
The voice of Norah Jones, Lee, Jim, Richard, and Dan. We've got the Little Willies on the WoodSongs Old Time Radio Hour. We're going to be back with a whole lot more music from their brand new CD, For the Good Times. Stay where we are. We'll be back right after this.
Hi, friends. This is your old buddy Ralph Stanley, and I'd like to tell you that you're listening to Michael Jonathan and the WoodSongs Old Time Radio Hour.
There's Dr. Ralph, good friend of the show. Just one of the songwriters on the Little Willies' brand new album, For the Good Times. We're celebrating that whole album full of great country, old-time country and Americana songs. Let's get back into the music. The CD is For the Good Times. This is a song called Foul Owl on the Prowl. It's the Little Willies on the WoodSongs Old Time Radio Hour.
Get out of the dark, foul owl on the prowl. Hey, little Jay, stay out of his way, foul owl on the prowl.
It just might be the quail he'll tame, foul owl on the prowl. It just might be the swallow he'll follow, foul owl on the prowl.
If you hear him hoot school, if you pass his tree flee, if you catch his eye fly, don't wait to say goodbye. if he catches a fly. Don't wait to say goodbye.
He's got a yen for a pretty little hen.
Music of the Little Willies from their new CD For the Good Times. It's a great record. Let's say hi to the guy sitting in the back, Dan Rieser, sitting out there. How are you doing, Dan? So, like, you've been around this music for a while. You were the one of the you were on the first Norah Jones album, the big album that scored big, right?
Yeah, played on part of that. Yeah.
Yes. So how did you become part of the Little Willies? How did this happen for you?
Well, yeah, again, it was pretty organic. You know, we were all in the same scene and all kind of playing together in various different projects. And I think I played with Norah when she first moved to town. And we just you know, again, it was just sort of out of
friendship.
But again, to have fun, to just get together and not, you know, we're all very intensely involved in like all these different projects and working very hard, and sometimes it can be, you know, you lose the fun aspect of it because you're working so hard. And this is just like, hey, let's just get together, play these songs that we love, and just have fun, no pressure.
Right. Now you've been playing drums just about your entire musical life. You started like when you were 10 years old.
Yeah, I was a kid. Yeah.
Yeah. So how why the drums? Why not the guitar? Why not, you know?
You know, I don't have any kind of cool explanation for that. It just always was. Yeah.
Because they're awesome.
Well, yeah. That's there you go. Thank you.
Let's get it up. We're gonna go to the first Little Willie's self-titled album. The tune is "Never Get Out of This World Alive." It is the Little Willie's on the WoodSongs Old Time Radio.
Tell you if it's heads or tails. If it was green and gold,
wouldn't stand a chance. I wouldn't have a pocket in my patched up pants. No matter how I struggle and strive, I'll never get out of this world alive. A distant uncle passed away. He left me quite a bad. Yes, and I was living high until that fatal day. A lawyer proved I wasn't born, I was only hatched. But I ain't gonna worry, wrinkles in my brow, 'cause nothing's ever gonna turn out right, no how, no matter.
Little Willies from their first CD. And Richard Julian doing a great job on the vocals on that one. Good
Thank
job.
You.
Dan Rieser pounding out the drums, rocking it out. Let's talk again to Norah Jones, sitting here on the piano and playing. Did you ever expect, when you first put out your first album, that it would end up with millions sold and all the Grammys that you won? I mean, that must have been a big surprise. Yeah. So what was that like for you?
That was an overwhelming time, which is why I started a band like this, so I could have fun and relax and not have to like worry about stuff.
Well, what's the part that takes the fun away? Because that's sort of been the theme of the whole evening, that that everybody collectively is here because they want to have fun. They have their individual careers, which they sort of put aside to come together as the Little Willies because mm-hmm. you're enjoying it. What's the hard part when you're in the middle of your rocket ship ride? And
all the stuff you do when you're not playing music. Answering questions. I mean, you know, answering questions and traveling and getting up early and all that crap.
Well, it's a lot of work to do this thing that they call playing, right?
Well, music should be fun, though. I think if I didn't have fun actually playing music when I did my own thing, I wouldn't do it. But I do. It's just the other stuff kind of takes it out of you. But
sure. Well, it must have been fun, like putting together the new album, selecting the songs, picking the songs that you would record and eventually release. I mean,
this album?
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, that's why we're here, because we had so much fun doing it. We were excited to do it other places. You know, we usually just do this band in New York, so this is really the first time we've kind of ventured out of New York to play for people.
Well, folks are obviously glad to see you. That's good. Let's go into the music of the album itself. Let's bring Lee up to the microphone. Selecting the songs, recording. Did you record just the 12 songs that you put on the album, or did you record a bunch more?
We recorded maybe, 15? Yeah. 15 songs, yeah.
So most of them were keepers then.
Most of them were, yeah.
Well, we're about to get into what I consider the most greatest track on the record, which is the Dolly Parton tune.
Right.
So tell me about the recording of this one. You're in the studio and you're saying, let's do a Dolly Parton song, right?
Well, we had already.
We tried to do this song on the first record, the first recording session, and we never really got it. It's been a really hard one to record. Live, we've hit it where it's felt like, well, that's it, but recording has been really hard, and I feel like we got it this time, so we decided to put it on the record. You know,
well, it's like fishing.
Yeah.
Kind of.
Waiting for the right moment.
Yeah.
Well, let's see if we can duplicate the magic. It's in their CD, For the Good Times. It is a Dolly Parton tune called Jolene. It's the Little Willies and the WoodSongs, Old Time Radio.
Jolene, 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 Jolene. don't take my man. Jolene, 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 please don't take him just because you can. Your beauty is beyond compare, with flaming locks of auburn hair, with ivory skin and eyes of emerald green. Your smile is like a breath of spring, your voice is soft like summer rain, and I cannot compete with you, Jolene. He talks about you in his sleep. There's nothing I can do to keep from crying when it calls your name, Jolene. And I could easily understand how you could easily take my man, but you don't know what he means to me, Jolene.
On their CD called For the Good Times, it's a brand new album by the Little Willies, Norah Jones on lead vocals, and Dan Rieser doing very tasty stuff on the drums in the back. Good job. Lee Alexander on bass, Richard Julian on guitar, and Jim Campilongo. And Jim, let's talk to you one more time here. You, New York Times raved about your guitar playing with Nora's vocal style and being in the Little Willies and stuff. So you're a very accomplished guy, very well respected in the music industry. You've got 9 albums of your own out. I want to give you, this is a surprise, and I apologize, we didn't talk about this ahead of time. Turn on your electric guitar. Uh-huh. Give me 60 seconds of mind-blowing.
Oh, yeah.
Bring the ceiling down guitar. Let's get back into the music. I can't believe the hour is just about over. The CD's called For the Good Times. This is a great song called Money Honey. It's the Little Willies on the WoodSongs, Old Time Radio.
You got the money, honey. I got the time. We'll go honky-tonking and we'll have a time. We'll have more fun, baby, all the way down the line. You got the money, honey. I got the time. Ain't no need to tarry, let's start out tonight. We'll have fun, oh boy, oh boy, and we will do it right. Bring along your Cadillac, be my wreck behind. You got the money, honey, I got the time. Short of money, I run short of time. You got no more money, honey, I got no more time.
Norah Jones on vocals, Lee Alexander on bass, Jim Campilongo on guitar, Richard Julian, Dan Rieser on drums.
Thank you.
So much fun. Norah, we've got about a minute before I've got to end the show. You've seen the music business change tremendously just in the last 5 years or so. What would you tell? We had a young girl on, 11 years old, that loved to sing, obviously. And, you know, if a young person was trying to start out the way you did several years ago, what advice would you give them to... The music business has changed. There's very few music stores left, no record stores left, and record companies are dissolving, or they're having a hard time finding the means to sign artists. So what advice would you give someone just starting out?
Well, I've always sort of made music that I love, and I think that's the key, kind of. I mean, you might struggle. Yes, the business has changed, but if you play music from the heart, from a place that is well-intended, and you're not changing who you are musically to fit with something, then that's going to come through no matter what the business is doing, I think.
Well, when you started out, you didn't start successful. You were a waitress. You were a working girl.
I got lucky. I mean, I never thought I would have this kind of success.
Well, we're glad you did, and we're glad that you're part of the Little Willies, and aren't we glad the Little Willies was on WoodSongs tonight? The thing that I think that we take away from our evening with the Little Willies is the importance of joy. No matter what you're doing, joy. You know, you can be an artist that sells millions of records. You can be a great guitar instructor and writing. You can be a great drummer and a bass player and a guitarist and a singer-songwriter and a wonderful vocalist. But if you're not having fun, why are you bothering? You know, we had a little 11-year-old girl come on the show at the mid-break who is filled with that joy and the excitement of this music. And music is changing. The one thing that hasn't changed is the joy that the audience gets when they hear a great artist singing a great song. You as an audience, you are such an integral, wonderful part of the joy that makes music and art so worthwhile. So we want to thank the audience all over the world for tuning in. My name is Michael Jonathan. I'm a folk singer. I am a tree hugger. We'll see you next week on the WoodSongs Old Time Radio. Good night.
You've been listening to WoodSongs broadcast number 647. Michael's opening song was Winter Song from the Ravenwood CD, featuring Jeff Hirschberger on cello, Jessica Zoe, Lubita Brakova, and Anna Hess on violin, Steve Franken on viola, and Bob Ryan on bass.
Our chief engineer is Kevin Darth Fader Johnson. Technical assistants are Brian Clausing, Brandon Eves, Eric Anderson, and Jerome Cyberboy Galt. Our television and internet broadcast.
Thank you for tuning in. There are so many talented artists that appear on our stage. It's very hard sometimes to pick the ones that appear on our TV broadcast. So what we're going to do is leave you with a performance from our huge online archive of past shows. We'll see you next time on the WoodSongs Old Time Radio Hour. This is the big single off of that album. It's called Way Over Yonder in a minor key. Woody Guthrie wrote the words, Billy Bragg on the WoodSongs Old Time Radio Hour.
Lived in a place called Oversky, and I had a little girl in a hollow tree. I said, little girl, it's plain to see there ain't nobody that can sing like me, nobody that can sing like me. Way over yonder in the minor key, way over yonder in the minor key, there ain't nobody that can sing like me. Oh, my little girlie, will you let me see way over yonder where the wind blows free? Ain't nobody can see in our hollow tree, and there ain't nobody that can sing like me, nobody that can sing like me. Way over yonder in the minor key, way over yonder in the minor key, there ain't nobody that can sing like me. To my tangled days, I've led lots of girls since then to stray, saying ain't nobody that can sing like me, nobody that can sing like me. Way over yonder in the minor key, way over yonder in the minor key, there ain't nobody that can sing like me. Way over yonder in the minor.
The television broadcast of the WoodSongs Old Time Radio Hour is made possible in part by Kentucky Proud and the Kentucky Department of Agriculture, supporting Kentucky-grown farm products used worldwide and in your hometown. Acoustic Rainbow, introducing songs from independent artists and small labels to over 1,200 acoustic format radio stations worldwide. Online at acousticrainbow.com. Support is also provided by viewers like you. Information on how to become a WoodSongs partner and support the growth of grassroots music is online at woodsongs.com. And by Insight Communications, providers of cable, high-definition television, and broadband internet service.